pink oyster. Come eat Italian oyster. Come eat blue oyster. Come eat snow pearl oyster. If you want to know what I'm talking about,
Hey
everyone, Wanda here, the Clark team. I'm here today with John, and we are at JCB Gourmet Mushrooms. And we are located
at 3765 Loggers Way in downtown Kinburn. Well, we're about five steps away from the suburbs.
You're going to learn a lot today about mushrooms.
And this is Italian oyster.
And John used to be a realtor, but now he does something much more interesting.
So what we grow are mushrooms that are native to hardwood trees. So everything we have, we use for the growing medium, is hardwood sawdust. And I buy it as pellets. So then we have two mixes. One uses soybean hull, and the other one uses wheat bran. So the green is the grayish green is the soybean hull. And the brown is the hardwood sawdust.
So we have we're growing the mushrooms.
Yep.
In hopes of what?
We're growing the mushrooms for consumption. They're all edible mushrooms. They're all mushrooms that are they're not necessarily local to this area, but they all have their characteristic taste. There's one, it's a pink oyster that tastes like bacon. We have, yes. We also have another mushroom. It doesn't look like anything you would ever think of as a mushroom. It looks like more like a hybrid between a cauliflower, a snowball, and a brain. When we sell our fresh mushrooms or our grow kits, we put in a recipe card.
Okay, so you sell mushrooms?
Yes.
Where?
We sell to grocery stores, restaurants, consumers, anybody who wants to come in here. We also do, like this year we did two home shows, so we were there. We sold grow kits, so, and we shipped the grow kits from coast to coast to Newfoundland to the West Coast.
John, if you were to order this is what you get?
So if you order a grow kit, this is what you get. So it says on here, you got the growing medium, which is like this. You get a humidity tent, which is this. Spray bottle. We also have the instructions, so it tells you what the flavor is. So it says mild, bacon, and nutty. The ideal temperature and the level.
Well, that's for me.
Yeah.
You can replace the word beginner with Wanda. Everybody would know what you're talking about.
And then a recipe card. These are natural flavors. We don't do anything to enhance them. We don't do anything to take away from their flavor. It's just, that's the way they are.
So you cut them this way and then they just grow through.
Yeah. So this is, so you just missed, Sarah just harvested.
I saw the big, snow oyster.
Yeah.
It was cool.
So this is
behind you.
So here's some snow oyster. And
so
we harvest on one side. When we're finished harvesting, we flip it over. And then now look underneath.
Oh.
So sometimes they'll continue growing so we can harvest on the other on the underside. But look at the color on that. And you can use it like a seasoning because it helps bring out the, you know, when you use a little bit of salt in your food, it just makes the flavor pop. That's what this does. So I never thought that I would ever get a mushroom that you could use as a seasoning, but that's it over there.
Cool. Also looks nice.
Yeah.
And as it gets older, it gets to be like a light tan color.
I'm taking off the old stuff and flipping it over and cutting it. Where did I put my knife?
So now it's going to start to pop out through these.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ideally. So this one has a bacon flavor, but
bacon flavor after it's been dried or
when you're cooking.
Okay.
So it's the most delicate of all the mushrooms that we grow. So when you're cooking it, it needs to be cooked at low temperature and slowly.
Do you like scallops?
Yes.
The Black King, it's a really thick stem. That one does great, makes a great scallop. So it looks, smells, and tastes just like scallops, but it's a mushroom.
So this would be good for somebody that's vegan?
Oh, definitely, yeah. Yeah.
And is that most of your clientele?
Nope.
No.
So vegan, somebody who wants to eat healthy, mm-hmm. Wants to eat more healthy alternatives to meat. There's some really good examples. And I'm always trying new types of mushrooms. There's so many things you can do with these mushrooms.
But is it expensive?
It is more expensive than the ones you buy in the store, but the ones you buy in the store, the regular mushrooms, the white button mushrooms, cremini and portobellos, those grow in huge beds of manure and straw. This technique, you need the bags because the bag is simulating the bark of the tree, and the contents. Well, once you cut the bag open, then they start growing out. So this was done on March 22nd. So you'll have, you see the little grain?
Yep.
So that's millet, and this is what it looks like. So you don't see much, but it's microscopic. So all this pink stuff are the spores. So we mix that in with the growing mix, and then this was done March 21st, so the day before. So this one is a slower growing mushroom, this is really fast, so this is one day difference. This is shiitake. So shiitake goes from brown to white, and then it turns dark chocolate brown. Smell that.
Yeah. Mmm. Sweet almost.
So much for the social distancing.